Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS presenting the theory lecture based on problem on modes and natural frequency. Before going to the problems, what is basic about the modes and natural frequency, that we have to see in this chapter. Let's see the 2 degree of freedom systems with the single degree of freedom system, that is that the two natural frequency, each of having different natural frequency and corresponding natural state of the vibration with the displacement configuration, that is called as what? Normal mode. What is the normal mode here? That the case is given, that is a 2 degree of freedom system differ from the single degree of freedom, is that the two natural frequencies of the, for each of this natural frequency, their corresponds are natural state vibration with the displacement configuration known as principal mode, and it will be the mathematical terms relative to this quantity is known as what? Eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So these are the conditions where we can say that we are having the 2 degree of freedom system differ from a single degree of freedom system, is that the two natural frequency and for each of this natural frequency corresponding natural state of the vibrations with displacement configuration is known as normal mode. And the mathematical terms related to this quantity is known as what? Eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So in short, we can say that natural state of vibrations with displacement configuration is known as what? Normal mode. And the mathematical terms related to this, that is called as what? Eigenvalues or eigenvector. So these are established from the two simultaneous equation of motions of system proposed certain dynamic properties. Okay, now some conditions given that for 100 certain conditions during the free vibrations, any move point in a system may execute the harmonic vibrations at any of the two frequencies, and amplitude are related in the specific manner, and configuration is known as normal mode or principal mode of vibration. Thus, system with 2 degrees of freedom has two normal modes of vibrations corresponding to the natural frequencies. The displacement measured from unstable positions of spring, let x1 and x2 be the displacement of masses m1 and m2 respectively at any instant of time measured from, look at these equilibrium conditions, positions with x2 is greater than x1. So these are the two spring configuration are given, then the forces acting on the masses is known as what? That k1 m1 K2, M2, X1, X2. So M1, X1, double dot. This is a particular inertia forces of mass M. K1, X1. This is a particular spring force. Then again K2 in bracket X2 minus X1. This is this spring force due to spring 2, then again K3 X2, this is the spring force due to the spring 3rd, M2 X2 double dot, this is the inertia force again due to the mass M. Now the Newton law of motions, what it indicates, that M1 X1 double dot is equal to minus K1 X1 plus K2 X2 minus X1. What Newton's second law indicate? That summation of all forces is equal to 0, means what? Inertia force and that of your external force addition is become 0 at the equilibrium conditions. So M1 X1 double dot is equal to minus K1 X1 plus K2 in bracket X2 minus X1. So M1 X1 double dot plus K1 X1 minus K2 X2 plus K2 X1, that is equal to 0. So the equation number 1, this is for all about the mass 1. What about the mass 2? M2 x2 double dot, that is equal to minus k3 x2 minus k2 in bracket x2 minus x1. m2 x2 double dot plus k3 x2 plus k2 x2 minus k2 x1 that is equal to 0. So m2 x2 double dot plus k2 k2 plus k3 x2 that is equal to k2 into x1. The solution of x1 and x2 are obtained by considering that the harmonic vibrations under the steady state motions, then considering the case of m1 execute the harmonic vibrations. So frequency omega 1 and m2 execute the harmonic vibration of the frequency omega 2. We have x1 is equal to capital x1 sine omega 1 t and x2 is equal to x2 sine omega 2 t. So from substituting the equation of 3 and into the equation of 1, what we get here, we got the minus m1 omega square x1 sine omega 1 t plus k2 plus k1 x1 sine omega 1 t that is equal to k2 x2 sine omega 2 t. Therefore x1 upon x2 is equal to k2 in bracket divided by k1 plus k2 minus m omega 1 square sine omega 2 t upon sine omega 1 t. Since x1 and x2 are amplitude of two harmonic motions, their ratios must be constant and independent of the time. Therefore omega sine omega 2 t upon sine omega 1 t that is equal to constant. Consider if c is greater than 1, then at a time t is equal to pi by 2 omega 1 sine omega 1 t will be sine of pi by 2 that is equal to 1. So sine omega 2t upon sine omega 1t that is equal to 1. So this is only possible if omega 2 omega 1 is equal to omega. X1 is equal to x1 sine omega t. X1 double dot is minus sine omega square x1 sine omega t. So x1 and x2 is equal to k2 in bracket k2 plus k1 minus m1 omega square. And also the x1 upon x2 is in bracket k2 plus k3 minus m2 omega square upon k2. Now considering the mass m1 and m2 is equal to m and k2 k1 plus k1 is equal to k3 is equal to k. By putting all this values, what we get here? So lambda is equal to omega square, lambda square is equal to omega raised to 4. Finally, we get m1 lambda square minus twice m, m bracket k plus k2 into lambda plus k square plus twice k1 k2 that is equal to 0. Thus, we got the omega n is equal to under root of k by m, omega n2 is equal to under root of k plus twice k2 that is upon m. Mode shapes x1 upon x2 is equal to k2 m bracket divided by k1 plus k2 minus m omega square. So x1 upon x2 omega n2 is equal to minus 1. So this is the case where we got that mode shapes. Figure A shows the m1, m2 and the k1, k2, k3. These are the respective springs. X1 is equal to 1. X2 is 2 in the case in case number 2. Mode shapes k1 and x2 is equal to minus 1. So first mode and these are the second wave mode. For first mode, omega n1 is equal to under root of k by m, while omega n2 is equal to what? The under root of k by k plus k twice k2 into m. What we observe here, omega n is equal to under root of k by m, and this is the case corresponding. If unequal displacement are given in the masses in any direction, the motion will be superpositions of the two harmonic motions corresponding to the two initial frequencies. So omega n is n1 is equal to under root of k by m, omega n2 is equal to under root of k plus twice k2 divided by m. So this is the case where we have seen that the x1 and x2 in the deflection in downward directions, while k1, k2, k3 is applying particular force in upward directions. Similarly, the inertia forces are acting in that direction also.
So this is all about the natural frequency omega n, omega n2, and that of your mode shapes. For the two masses and three swings are there.